Welcome to Jeremy's IT Lab. This is a complete course for the CCNP ENCOR, Enterprise Core exam. In this lab, we will analyze a LAN to determine the STP topology, the root bridge, root ports, designated ports, and non-designated ports. It's very important that you can do this confidently. So let's look at the lab instructions. They are fairly simple. First, without using the CLI, determine the STP topology of the LAN. And for bonus points, instead of non-designated, identify the alternate and backup roles of blocking ports. So classic STP has the non-designated role, but RSTP has alternate and backup. However, as I showed in the lecture video, even when running classic 802.1D STP, in the output of show spanning tree, non-designated ports will show up as alternate or backup, not non-designated. In the lecture video, I didn't cover the difference between alternate and backup ports, but hopefully you remember from your CCNA studies. Okay, when we're done, the final instruction is to use the CLI to confirm our answers. And before we get started, I want to point out that I modified the bandwidth of Switch 2 and Switch 3's G10 ports, this connection between Switch 2 and Switch 3, to 100 megabits per second. So that will affect their cost. Also, there are two hubs in this LAN. To represent hubs, I'm using the CML unmanaged switch node. It floods all frames like a hub. Let's get started. The first step in determining the STP topology is to find the root bridge, the central point of reference for the STP topology. The switch with the lowest bridge ID will be the root bridge. Now, each switch's MAC address will be different when you load this lab than when I load this lab. So to control which switch becomes root, I modified their priorities. And switch 3 has the lowest priority, so it will be the root bridge. Next, all non-root switches will select one root port. Let's go in order, starting with switch 1. The first criteria is lowest root cost. Switch 1 is directly connected to the root bridge, so it receives BPDUs with a cost of 0. Then, it adds the cost of the receiving port, or ports in this case, G00 and G01. Now, which of the two will become the root port? The first tiebreaker is neighbor bridge ID, which is the same, both connect to switch 3. And the next tiebreaker is neighbor port ID. Once again, both are connected to the same segment and receive the same BPDUs from switch 3. So they are tied once again. So the final tiebreaker is the lowest local port ID. With the default port priorities, G00's port ID will be 128.1 and G01's 128.2, so G00 wins. Therefore, G00 will be switch 1's root port. I'll mark G00 as R. Next up, switch 2's root port. Now, switch 2 also has a direct link to the root bridge via G10. So it also receives BPDUs with a cost of 0 from the root. However, when it adds the cost of G10, it adds a cost of 19. That's because I modified the interface's bandwidth to 100 megabits per second. So G10 actually won't become the root port. That's because switch 2's root cost is 8 via G00, 1, 2, and 3. It learns a cost of 4 from switch 1 and switch 4, and adds 4 for each of its receiving ports. So the tiebreaker is neighbor bridge ID. Switch 4 has a lower bridge ID than switch 1, so that means that either switch 2 G02 or G03 will be the root port, not G00 or G01. The next tiebreaker is lowest neighbor port ID. Once again tied. Switch 2 and switch 4 are also connected via a hub. That means we once again have to proceed to the final tiebreaker, lowest local port ID. So, switch 2 G02 becomes the root port, which I'll mark here. Finally, switch 4. It has two 1 gig connections to the root bridge, both with a root cost of 4. The neighbor bridge ID is a tie, both are connected to switch 3. Now this time there isn't a neighbor port ID tie. Switch 4 G02 is connected to switch 3 G02, and switch 4 G03 is connected to switch 3 G03. G02 has a lower neighbor port ID, so switch 4 G02 wins and becomes the root port, and I'll mark that here. Okay, we have identified all of the root ports in the LAN. Next, let's identify the designated and non-designated ports. Straight away, I can mark switch 3G02 across from switch 4's root port as a designated port. And actually switch 3G03 and G10 also. Remember, the root bridge will always have the designated port for each segment. These three segments are point-to-point connections, no hub, so we know that switch 3's ports are designated. As for G00 and G01, they are both connected to the same segment, so only one will be designated. What's the rule for deciding which one? It's the one with the lower port ID, so I'll mark switch 3G00 as a designated port. It has a lower port ID than switch 3G01. Now, I could mark switch 3G01 as non-designated, but let's think of the alternate and backup distinction. Which is G01, alternate or backup? I will explain this when we cover RSTP in this course, but it will be backup because it is connected to the same segment as a designated port on the same switch. So I'll mark switch 3G01 as backup. And now, switch 3 is done. To confirm, I'll open the CLI of switch 3. Enable, and let's check with show spanning tree. So I marked G00 designated, G01 backup, and the others designated. As we can see here, that is correct. One thing I want to point out is that the cost column here lists the individual cost value of each port, which is automatically calculated from the port's bandwidth value. These values do not represent switch 3's root cost via each port. Switch 3 is the root bridge, so it has a root cost of 0. Okay, let's move on. What about switch 1 on this same segment connected to switch 3? G00 is a root port, so what about G01? Switch 1 G01 is connected to the same segment as a designated port on a different switch. So G01 will be an alternate port, which I'll mark here. Like I said, I'll explain this distinction more later in the course. Now, switch 1 and switch 2 have two connections. Switch 1 G02 to switch 2 G01, and switch 1 G03 to switch 2 G00. How do we decide which side of each connection will be designated, and which will be non-designated or alternate? The first step is, the port on the switch with the lowest root cost will be designated. Remember, we are not comparing the cost of switch 1 G02 to the cost of switch 2 G01, or the cost of switch 1 G03 to the cost of switch 2 G00. We are comparing switch 1's root cost via its root port to switch 2's root cost via its root port. Switch 1's root cost is 4, and switch 2's root cost is 8. So that means switch 1's ports, G02 and G03, will be designated, which I'll mark here. And switch 2's ports, G00 and G01, will be non-designated, which I'll mark as alternate. In a point-to-point connection between switches, you won't encounter backup ports, only alternate. Next, let's look at switch 2's remaining ports. For this direct link to switch 3, we've already determined that switch 3 G10 is designated. So switch 2 G10 must be non-designated, or alternate, which I'll mark here. Then, what about G03, connected to switch 4 via a hub? Well, there must be one designated port per segment. We've already determined that switch 2 G02 is a root port. So which of the remaining three ports will be the designated port? Switch 2 G03, switch 4 G00, or switch 4 G01? Let's compare root costs. Switch 4's root cost is 4, via its root port, G02. Switch 2's root cost is 8, via its root port, G02. So that means switch 4 wins. One of its ports will be designated. Because switch 4 G00 and G01 are both connected to the same segment, they have tied neighbor bridge IDs and neighbor port IDs. So the local port with the lowest port ID will become designated. And that is switch 4 G00, which I'll mark here. Okay, we have two ports left to identify on this segment, switch 2 G03 and switch 4 G01. We know that both of them are blocking ports, so regarding classic STP, we can say that they are both non-designated, but let's distinguish between alternate and backup. Switch to G03 will be alternate because it's connected to a designated port on a different switch, switch 4 G00. And switch 4 G01 will be backup because it's connected to a designated port on the same switch, G00. Okay, there's one port remaining to identify, switch 4 G03. This segment already has a designated port, switch 3 G03, so switch 4's port must be non-designated, an alternate port. And now we're done. We already confirmed on switch 3, so let's go through the remaining three switches and confirm in the CLI, switch 1 first. Enable, show spanning tree. I marked root, alternate, designated, designated, and that is correct, as you can see here. Perfect. Then I'll check on switch 2. Enable, show spanning tree. So I marked all ports except G02, the root port, as alternate. And that is correct. Alternate, alternate, root, alternate, alternate. Finally, let's check switch 4. Enable, show spanning tree. G00 is designated, G01 is backup, G02 is root, and G03 is alternate. One port of each role. So switch 4 is correct too. Okay, in this lab, we analyzed a LAN and determined the STP topology. This is just the first part of the STP section of this course. In following videos, we will dig into more aspects of STP, such as STP tuning and the STP toolkit, as well as RSTP and MSTP. Okay, that's all for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thanks for watching. Before finishing this video, let me thank my JCNP level channel members. To become a member, please click the join button under the video. Thanks to Jonathan Makara, Velva Jacob, Funny Dart, Nasir Chowdhury, Devin Suku, Gustavo BR, Marcel Lord, Pavel M, Mr. Erlison, Dragos Hirnea, Zakib Shah, Mayor Salman, Mazen Anderson, Vitaus 194, Gina Lindley, Mark Jackson, Bold 1C1U, Michael Carroll, Gerald Guillaume, Gabriel Braga, Hector Hernandez, Mara Tuba, Roji Kuriakos, Arpad Konivez, 5 Feet, Owad, Daniel Brown, Tricky Mickey 123456, Scott Thompson, Jose Alvarez, Hussein Yavuz, Kevin Hayes, Samuel Tavares, Roger Bratseth, Mustafa Ersoy, Nasser Zahar, Brian Grant, Georgi Gemejev, Kyle, Arlen Plagaria, Dear Diso, Adelson Pereira, Farad 69, Joyce Njoroge, Lucien Stojatoyu, Madmark 50484, Sean Powell, Alexandru Stratan, Hiago Bicalho, Abdo Zizo, Pieter Kaimov, DMJ2, Kurt Nell, Preeti Dongave, Abubakar Berry, Omid Farakesh, Steve Cox, Jasper Yim, Wilmer Romero, Enigma G, Laurent Lam, Emmanuel Nupsido, Pedro Hartman, Ivano Capuano, Jefferson Steelflex, Sinan Sarisinar, Alejandro Okana, Burul Campbell, Abhishek Sahu, Toxic, Gio, Daniel Andrade, Vijay Kumar Pili, Jairo Francisco, Dedenoyu Diana, Hamudi Batman, Mike Crumby, and Eliel Eliluli. Sorry if I pronounced your name incorrectly, but thank you so much for your support. Thanks to you and my other supporters, I am able to make these videos and release them for free on YouTube, so I really appreciate the support. Another great way to support the channel is to like the video, leave a comment, subscribe, and most importantly, share this video with others. So if this video was helpful, I'd appreciate it if you did any of those. Thanks for watching.